Now, let's draw three circles, generic circles, that are separated like this in space. Given a pair of circles, for example, large and middle, you can draw a common tangent to those two circles, like so and like so. To be precise, we are drawing two outer tangents, because you can cross these like this, a tangent and tangent. They are inner tangents that cross, but let's talk about the outer tangents. And those two outer tangents, these circles are usually of different sizes, will meet at the vertex or tip, which I'll mark in black dot. Okay. And because they are three pairs, large and middle, middle and small and large, there are three pairs of tangents. And the theorem is that if you take the tip of the first pair, tip of the second pair of tangents, and tip of the third pair of tangents, they are all aligned along a straight line. What are the chances that three arbitrary points on a plane aligned along a straight line? Zero. But in this case, they do align very, very beautifully along a straight line. This theorem goes back, as far as I know, to a French mathematician engineer called Monge, one of the founders of École Polytechnique in Paris. And he is very famous for descriptive geometry and the Rambler and Deblay, so the how to move a pile of stuff from here to there, minimizing energy and cost and that kind of research. But he also has a few contributions in elementary geometry like this. And this is provable by different methods. For example, Menelaus and so forth will do it in a classical method, but there is a very, very beautiful approach, which again has to do with lifting the whole picture to the three dimensions. Instead of those three circles, let's imagine that these are actually pictures of three spheres as seen from above. Please imagine that those three spheres are sitting on the same table. In other words, their centers are at different heights. Large one will be lifted a lot, and the small one will be lifted only a small amount, and middle one a little middle-ish, but they're all sitting on the same tables. Given, say, a large ball and a middle ball, you can draw a common tangent cone. So cone like an ice cream cone, so something that a surface like this, which sort of expands, and which sort of shrinks to a tip. And if you look at that picture from above, you see what we saw before, that is two circles and a pair of common tangent lines, yeah, and a tip. So you can interpret that picture as actually a three-dimensional picture, but seen in two-dimensional appearance. Okay. And because there are three balls, large and middle will have a cone and a tip, middle and small will have a cone and a tip, and small and large, tip, cone and tip, you have three tips of those three cones. On the other hand, please imagine again those three spheres sitting on a common floor. And now, if you please, take a transparent ceiling from above and just tilt it, and just lower it so that it touches those three spheres at the same time from above. You have to tilt it, yeah? It's not, you can't be horizontal, you have to tilt it and it touches those three spheres at the same time. So you have now a ceiling which touches those three spheres from above, and the floor which touches those three spheres from below. Each of those cones that we talked about, for example, this cone between large and middle sphere, well, it's touching the ceiling and the floor at the same time, this cone. So the tip of this cone is inside the ceiling and inside the floor at the same time, okay? And the same goes for the other two tips. So all those tips of the cones are in the top plane, that is the ceiling, and the bottom plane, that is the floor, at the same time. But, you know, those two planes in space intersect along a straight line. So we have just shown that those tips of cones are along a straight line. And which, what is that straight line? It's the intersection of the ceiling that we put from above and the floor on which we put the balls. And if you look at that picture from above, you see this picture. So that dotted line is the intersection of the ceiling, which is tilting like that, and then the floor, which is supporting the thing from below. You can also see a cartoon. You just lift this, and then that's the ceiling, pi prime, that I denoted, and the floor is pi. And then the common cone, and tangent cone to these two spheres is like that, and tip is lying in the intersecting line between the ceiling and the floor. Okay. So by lifting the this complicated problem to the third dimension, the problem goes away. In fact, if you look at it the right way, you know, there used to be one of those interesting pictures where you look at it with some out of focus sight, suddenly it jumps out to you into a 3D. And it's a bit like this. If you look at it the right way, you can start seeing it like a three-dimensional picture, and then the theorem is clear. There's no problem. I mean, of course, these three points must be on the same line because that's how I see it.
This is actually a sequel to a previous video with the professor about earthquakes and spheres. Hopefully you've caught that one too. Or if you just want to see more videos with the professor, click on the link that's on the screen or in the video description. And while you're in the video description, you'll find details about these Numberphile playing cards, which are coming soon.